get ready to lace up. We're taking you inside high school basketball, your home team, your rivals, inside the action, inside the excitement, inside all the games that count. Taking you inside high school basketball like no one else can. This is Inside High School Sports with Pat Doney.
Welcome to Inside High School Sports. I am your host, Pat Doney. The boys' state tournament taking place this weekend in San Antonio, and North Texas had its share of teams playing in championship games. But let's start with the semifinal matchups. Plano East was hoping to finish its dream season with a perfect 40-0 record, but in order to do that, the Panthers had to get win number 39 first, and that would mean beating another DFW team in the semis. In Mansfield Lake Ridge, the Eagles were making their first trip to state and hungry for an upset. Lake Ridge and Plano East is our Whataburger game of the week. Lake Ridge head coach Cornelius Mitchell and his team needed to basically be perfect to stop the unbeaten Plano East Panthers, and the Panthers come out firing. Narit Shodi Kavanagh having it working from beyond the arc, knocking down the straightaway shot there. Next time down, he's open in the corner, and he knocks that down as well. Shodi Kavanagh finished with 11. Back comes Lake Ridge. Amari Rose gets the steal and goes all the way. Watch him take it in for the one-handed hammer. Plano East, though, with a four-point lead at halftime. Second half now, the Panthers still hot, and it's still from behind the arc. This time it's John Tran from the corner. Rattling at home, pure stroke there. Lake Ridge keeping pace, thanks to Amir McMillan, who was on fire from mid-range, knocking down the 15-footer for two of his game-high 18 points. Then it's Plano East's DJ Hall getting involved as he gets the nice dish from Richard Angton and drops home the deuce. Plano East wins 61-45 over Mansfield Lake Ridge to advance to the state championship game. More on that in just a bit. The number one ranked Lancaster Tigers, led by former bobblehead winner Dylan Batty, battling Amarillo in the 5A semifinal game Thursday night. The Tigers' defense was stingy early. DeAntre Barrett steps in front of the pass and lays it home in the open court for two. Another Tiger takeaway here, and this time it's Batty getting to finish it off as he avoids the defender for the nice bucket right there. Points hard to come by in this one. Lancaster had just a 13-8 lead at halftime. Second half now, Lancaster's defense standing strong. This time it's Desmion Jones getting the steal and going in for the bucket, giving the Tigers this week's defensive title belt award. Amarillo kept it close. Braden Hawson going off the glass here for two of his game-high 14, but Batty and company would take care of business down the stretch. He gets three the hard way here, finished with 13. The Tigers advance to play Colleen Ellison in the 5A state championship game with a 44-31 victory. Head coach Brandon Thomas and Faith Family looking for the three-peat in 4A before moving to 5A next year, taking on Stafford out of the Houston area in a state semifinal. Eagles went on a 16-0 run in the first quarter. That's Jazz Henderson for three. Then Henderson on the break, tossing the alley-oop to Isaac Williams for the dunk. And then continuing the fast break theme, Henderson leads Lamont Hartfield for another layup. And then finally, it's Williams finishing the run with a steal and a breakaway dunk. Williams finished with 19 points. Faith Family led 20-8 after one. It went on from there. Williams, the nice moves, and then the fadeaway jumper at the buzzer. The Eagles win 59-40 and advance to play Silsbee in the final. We'll have those highlights in a bit as well. All right, the 6A state final pitted undefeated Plano East against Stony Point, whose only loss came against Plano East earlier this year. Plano East gets started with a nice pass to DJ Hall here for the quick flip. Panthers up early. Stony Point, led by Villanova commit Josiah Mosley, strips the ball here, and he goes in for a layup. Tracy McGrady, impressed with the youngster hanging out in the crowd. If he was impressed with him, well, he had to like Hall as well. No one covers him from beyond the arc, so the big fella drops the three ball. He scored a quick 9 points for the Panthers. Then it was Rashard Angton driving, using the rim to stave off the defender with the reverse layup. Plano East led 15-11 after one. More Angton in the second quarter. He takes off down the baseline and tosses up the high floater. The Panthers up 29-24 at the half, and they go on to finish the job from there. Plano East is your undefeated 6A state champion, finishing off a 40-0 season, winning the state title game 53-41 the final. Dylan Batty leading his number one ranked Tigers against Colleen Ellison in the 5A state title game, and the Tigers came out on fire. Here they get the steal, and Cardae Turner Gets it to Desmond Jones, who buries the three right here. That gives Lancaster the quick 9-0 lead. The Tigers stay hot from behind the arc. This time it's Jace Tarver from the corner, helping Lancaster build an 8-point halftime lead. We go to the second half now. The Tigers start to punish the rim. Amari Reed absolutely posterizes an Ellison player here, and he was not done. How about another one? Great ball movement. Reed again, hammering home another two-hander. He finished with 14. Then it's Batty getting in the act. Just skying high for a nasty one-handed throwdown. Batty scored a game-high 17 on his way to MVP honors. But more importantly, it led the Tigers to a victory. Lancaster is your state champion once again with a convincing 59-30 win over Killeen Ellison. And Lancaster head coach Farron Douglas certainly proud of his team.
Being away for 4 years, it's hard getting out of Region 2, man. I promise you, it's a lot of great coaches, great teams, great players that come from Dallas, you know. So it's just tough getting out of there. These guys worked hard.
Faith family looking for a three-peat in the 4A final against Silsbee, and boy, did they have fun in this one, especially Isaac Williams, who wanted to make his final high school game a special one. Great reverse layup right there. And then he proves he can strike from distance as well. Watch him knock down the three-pointer here, a pure stroke. Still in the first, it's Williams off the steal. He's going to go in for a two-handed dunk, 22-9 Eagles after one. Former bobblehead winner Dorian Onwuchekwa gets in the act. The two-handed stuff. He finished with 19 points and 14 rebounds. Isaac Williams was not done with his highlights either. Doing a little cherry picking, finishing it off with a ferocious dunk. The MVP Williams scored 32 points. Faith family coasts to another title with an 80-66 victory.
I was locked in from the beginning. I knew, I mean, like I said before, it's meant a lot to me because I was injured last year, so I just wanted to show everybody in Texas that, you know, I can do this, so I feel like I did that.
Ponder taking on Hitchcock in the 3A state championship first quarter. Great pass from Timber Kreider to Max Hutcherson coming right here, and it's a layup, and we're tied at 9. Second quarter now. The Lions create some separation with their three-point shooting. Cade Irons with a deep ball to give Ponder the lead. The Lions tied a 3A record with 10 threes made in their semifinal. And in the championship, they hit 6, including this one from Hutcherson, who finished with 19. Ponder up 31-21 at half. Third quarter, they extend the lead to 13. When Kreider took it strong to the hole there, but Hitchcock would turn up the pressure. And when Damian McDaniel got this steal and went in for the layup to put the Bulldogs up 3 with a minute to play, it was all over for the Lions. Ponder loses in the title game, 53-49.
I use the term grit a lot, resilient. They didn't fold, they didn't waver. They kept showing up to practices that lasted 2.5 to 3 hours a day, knowing that that's what it was going to take for us to accomplish what we wanted to accomplish.
All right, let's take a time out from the state highlights to introduce you to one of the area's most elite athletes. She helped lead her team to the 6A state title game and took her game to the next level after some serious injuries left her team shorthanded. Talia Parker of South Grand Prairie is this week's Parker University MVP. When South Grand Prairie lost star post player Adele Tack for the year early in the season, they needed a new leader to step up. Cue Talia Parker. The 6'1" senior guard took over and helped lead the Warriors to the state championship game. Parker plays with intensity and a competitive edge on both ends of the court, and when she decides to go to the hole, she does it with purpose. She averaged 11 points, 5 rebounds, and 4 assists for SGP, and will be taking her talents to College Station to play for Texas A&M next winter. I love watching her play, making plays all over the court, Talia, and she's in studio now with her new bobblehead. Congratulations. What do we think of the bobblehead? I think it's a pretty good one here now.
Thank you. It looks just like me.
It's well-deserved. It's been so fun to watch you play. One thing we mentioned in that story, your intensity, and that's something that as I'm getting to know you in person, kind of surprises me. You're very sweet, you know, but on the court, you're somebody who can turn that on in a big way. Mm-hmm. Is that something that's come pretty easily to you? Are you always very intense on the floor?
Yes, I would definitely say this is something that just had to grow on me. I was a very shy kid growing up, so this was something that had to get taken out of me.
And then this year, you really stepped your game up. Yeah. When Adele Tax, someone who won a bobblehead as well earlier this year, went out with injury. She ended up going to South Carolina. And it felt like maybe, I mean, we heard maybe some doom and gloom vibes. But then you guys make it all the way to the state championship game. What happened? How were you guys able to overcome that?
So I'm actually glad we faced early adversity.
It's just a challenging circumstance, and yet, and you were able to overcome that, though. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, was there something that you think that this group really rallied around, or how did you guys come together in that moment there?
So I think it was right after Adele was leaving and she got injured. We had came together as a team and knew, like, we got this. Like, we are a better team than we expected.
I love the way that you guys approached that, mm-hmm. too. And I think that's probably going to play into this next question here about what you're going to remember about your time at SGP. So many great memories, so many great moments in an awesome program. When you think back to your time, what do you think is going to stand out about your time playing for the Warriors?
Definitely my teammates. Everybody on the team is good. That's one thing I'm really going to miss about them. The memories we shared, the hotels. I'm going to miss them.
A lot of great moments for sure. And just really quickly, I want to ask you about Texas A&M. Yeah. You could have played a lot of different places. Mm-hmm. You're headed to College Station. Why were the Aggies the right fit for you to play college basketball?
The traditions, the coaching staff, the conference, the style of play, all of the above. Yeah. I knew that was the place for me.
So many great opportunities there for you. I can't wait to watch you there. It's been so fun to watch you at South Grand Prairie. Taliyah, congratulations on a great career, and I appreciate you being with us here in studio.
Thank you.
All right, up next, we are back to the championship games, recapping the girls' state title matchups. Stay with us. Last weekend was the girls' state tournament, and in the two largest classifications, the matchups were all Dallas-Fort Worth battles. Let's take a look back at those two state title games in our inside story. In the 6A girls' final, Duncanville, under first-year head coach Neiman Ford, was looking for their 12th state title as they took on a South Grand Prairie team playing without star Adele Tack, who has been hurt all season long, and forward Erica Carr, who got injured in the state semifinal. But that did not stop the Warriors from taking the early lead. Taliyah Parker went strong to the hole for 2 of her 10 points, and junior star Taylor Barnes knocked down a baseline jumper. She scored 14 to lead SGP, and the Warriors led 16-11 after a quarter. But after foul trouble became an issue for South Grand Prairie and the Pantherettes decided to go to the cup and try and draw more fouls, the game changed. Kaylin Kent got the tough bucket, and then Mariah Clayton drove to the hole for the basket and the foul, and Duncanville entered halftime with just a one-point deficit. In the second half, the Pantherettes went with a steady dose of Cincinnati commit Chloe Mann and more Clayton, who finished with 19 points and a finals MVP. Duncanville proved to be too much down the stretch. They pull away and win 59-41. The Pantherettes went from being banned from the postseason last year to state title number 12 in 2024.
You couldn't even imagine the will to win these ladies have. The way they come and just impose their will. And I preach about it all the time. I said, sometimes it's not the skill of the woman, but it's the will of the woman that's going to get you through in these tough times.
Nobody thought that we would be here right now as we are, but as you can see, we like to prove people wrong, so that's what we're going to continue to keep doing. I say we. That's what they're going to continue to keep on doing.
In the 5A title, nationally ranked Mansfield Timberview and head coach Kit Kyle Martin took a 37-game winning streak into a matchup against defending state champion Frisco Liberty and the nation's top sophomore, J.C. Abee. Early on, it was a heavy dose of Abee, who scored 12 points in the first half. Doing most of her damage, taking it to the hole, Abee was a problem for the Lady Wolves. But Timberview would counteract with Emily Jones. The senior scored 23 points and would make shots from inside and out. And she wasn't alone either, as Krishan Coleman put up 17 points as well. Timberview would extend a 7-point halftime lead to 12 early in the third. But that's when Abee took control. Not only was she scoring, as she finished with 30 points and 12 rebounds, but she was finding her teammates too. On the break, she connected with Isaiah Ferrier in the corner for three, and suddenly the Red Hawks had a 51-48 lead in the fourth. And while Timberview only made one basket in the fourth, Abee and her teammates, like Kiara Roseby, were filling the cup as Liberty went on to a 60-51 win. The Red Hawks are repeat 5A state champs.
Really, all I can say is, like, what a ride to end my senior year with a W, with a state championship. It's just a really good feeling. and I'm glad to do it with my teammates.
Someone's always watching, and I just always have to put on like my best show, the best reputation I can. And then I think I'm just learning as I go, to be honest. I mean, I'm trying to be a person that I would look up to as well, just because I'm so young and I know that I have so much time left. And I just wanted to not only get the ring for my team, but get it for me.
All right, when we come back, we take a look at another South Grand Prairie guard as we go next level. Brent Gaylor and his Lipan Indians in the 2A state final against Shelbyville. End of the third, it's Coach Gaylor's son, Court Gaylor, beating the buzzer for three. Lipan up 32-27 after three. Fourth quarter, the Indians go inside to Darius Steed for a basket off the glass. And then it's Gaylor again. He's just a freshman, but 23 big points and the game's MVP as Lipan wins state 47-36, the final. Well, earlier in the show, we talked about South Grand Prairie guard Talia Parker. She's a standout player for the Warriors, but unfortunately for them, she's graduating. However, Sean McFarland from the Dallas Morning News tells us in this week's Golden Chick Next Level that the future still looks good for the Warriors thanks to another dynamic junior guard.
Most girls' basketball teams that lose a five-star South Carolina signee to a season-ending injury before the season really even begins usually aren't still competing come March. Most teams, that is. That's because most teams don't also have Taylor Barnes like South Grand Prairie did. Barnes, a nationally ranked four-star recruit according to ESPN, stepped up in the wake of a Del Tac season-ending injury and led South Grand Prairie back to the state tournament for the third time in four seasons. The junior averaged a team-high 14 points per game in the regular season for South Grand Prairie and even stepped her game up in the postseason. She scored 14 points and pulled down 8 rebounds in the 6A state title game against Duncanville and had 24 points and 12 rebounds against San Antonio Brennan in the state semifinals. And in the regional semifinals, she scored 25 points to help South Grand Prairie eliminate Salt Lake Carroll. At 6 feet tall, she's a smooth, quick release from three-point range. Teams are going to have to see that a lot next season when she's a senior. Barnes could be the top-ranked recruit in DFW next season. With Adele Tack and Talia Parker set to graduate from South Grand Prairie, Barnes will become the focal point of a team that's trying to make it back to San Antonio.
She is a good one. Thank you, Sean. Time for one last timeout. When we return, it's our Kroger Plays of the Week. All right, that's going to do it for this week's show. Thank you for watching Inside High School Sports. I'm Pat Doney. We leave you with our Kroger Plays of the Week.